In this topic, we are going to discuss the stages of internationalization model. We are talking about the organizational context of an organization when it goes international. The organizational structure of an organization changes as it goes through different stages of internationalization. What are those stages? We need to understand that. And a model is shown in order to understand those stages. It is not necessary that an organization follows that exact path that is shown in the model. Models are always made to make you understand the reality, but reality is not always according to the models. It may vary slightly, but it does give us an understanding about what may be happening in the real environment. So you can see in this model that there are various stages of internationalization. An organization may go through these stages very quickly. An organization may skip the stages which are shown in this model. Ye zaruri nahi hai ke koi organization internationalization ke liye in stages se hi cross karke next stages ke upar jaye. It is possible it may go to the third stage directly. But it is important for us to understand what are the various different possibilities through which an organization goes through when it goes through the evolutionary phases of internationalization. You can see in this model that the first stage of internationalization is exporting. Exporting is when an organization has its production and manufacturing in the parent country and they are exporting, selling their products or services in other countries. So you are exporting. The second stage is sales subsidiary. Sales subsidiary mein kya hota hai? Ke aap foreign country mein apne ya to foreign agents ko appoint kar lete hain ya aap apni koi wahan par shop open kar lete hain, apna retail store open kar lete hain. You become an organization which sells directly in the foreign country. So you're not exporting, you are selling from the sale point in the foreign country. So that is your sale subsidiary. For example, ab khadi ki misal le lein. Khadi has got many sales subsidiaries in various different countries. It has got in Dubai, it has got subsidiary in UK, in Paris, and many different countries of this world. So having a sales point and sales outlet in another foreign country makes you a sales subsidiary. Then the third step is foreign production. Isme aap kya karte hain ke aap apni manufacturing foreign countries mein karna shuru kar dete hain. So aapne bahut sari multinationals ki example dekhi hongi jinke production plants Pakistan mein lage hue hain. For example, Coca-Cola, for example, Nestle, for example, McDonald's. So all these organizations, they have production facilities in the foreign country. They belong to another parent country and they have production facilities in other foreign countries. And then finally, the last step of this model is network of subsidiaries, in which you may have some sales subsidiaries in a foreign organization and you have many production facilities in many different foreign countries, and that becomes a network of your multinational subsidiaries. So you can see in the environment that there are many organizations who have a network of subsidiaries in the entire world. These are the stage-wise steps of internationalization. You can see in this model that there are some dotted lines. And from this, you can see that it is not necessary that a company should go through exporting, sales subsidiary, foreign production, and then network. It may go for licensing. Export karne ke baad aap apna license kisi foreign country mein kisi organization ko de sakte hain, franchise de sakte hain. Aur phir wahan se aap licensing se aap foreign production ki taraf ja sakte hain. Dusri aapki option ye ho sakti hai ki aap exporting se subcontracting ki taraf chale jayein. जिसमें में सब कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग में आप ये करते हैं कि आप पार्शल जो है मर्जर कर सकते हैं किसी के साथ जॉइंट वेंचर कर सकते हैं और फिर वहाँ से आप फॉरेन प्रोडक्शन के अंदर चले जाएं तो यू आर एक्चुअली नॉट गोइंग थ्रू दैट डायरेक्ट पाथ यू आर चेंजिंग द मोड ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड यू आर चेंजिंग द मोड ऑफ इंटरनेशनलाइजेशन इन दैट सिनेरियो. So then you can go for foreign production, and then it's possible that some companies may also go for subcontracting and then directly go towards network of subsidiaries in the international context. For example, McDonald's is one of the examples which go for subcontracting and then they have become a network of subsidiaries in the entire world. Why do organizations go through these evolutionary changes? Why don't they stick to one step of exporting or to sales subsidiary? It is because when an organization grows, there are strains that are imposed by the growth and geographical spread. So when an organization spreads its operations, unki sales jab badh jati hai, unki demand badh jati hai, तो ये पॉसिबल नहीं रहता कि आप एक कंट्री में ऑपरेट करते हुए सारी डिमांड्स को फुलफिल कर सकें. सो यू हैव टू गो इनटू फॉरेन प्रोडक्शन, यू हैव टू मेक ए नेटवर्क इफ यू आर योर स्केल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ग्रोज टू दैट एक्सटेंट. देन यू हैव द नीड फॉर कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड कंट्रोल अक्रॉस बिजनेस यूनिट्स. सो यू कैन नॉट जस्ट स्प्रेड in an organic manner. You need to go for a structured growth pattern in which you need to streamline your operations and maximize efficiency. And then there are constraints that are imposed by the host government regulations on ownership and equity. So if the host government requires that you cannot go into production, or if you are selling to a certain extent, you have to have a production facility within the that particular country, then you have to go for foreign production. So therefore, there are constraints which are applied to your international operations, which demand this evolutionary growth.